Gentlemen, boys and girls, and any who may identify otherwise, thank you all for coming along tonight to our performance of...
Sleeping Beauty Bob.
Of Sleeping Beauty Bob. Now, where was I? Sorry. Ah, yes, if I could remind you all to turn off your mobile phones and remember that in the unlikely event of a fire, our exits are here, 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 and here. And our fire assembly point is the car park outside. Thank you all, and I hope you enjoy the show.
Sleeping buffet. I never want to turn down free food and cubes of cheese and pineapple and tiny wooden sticks. I'll do anything for free food. Did you know Papa Cy will give you a free curly whirly with your cheesy chips if you're crying at the end of a night out? As far as he's concerned, my grandmother's died of 29 different diseases, and I've had more breakups than Taylor Swift.
You mean boyfriends have breakups, Natty? Well, you silly goose.
I'm sorry, I don't normally take advice from... Remind me, what was your name again?
Villager number one.
I'm sorry, what?
Villager number one!
Right. Well, villager number one, as it happens, I have a Tinder date after this.
Really? Who's going to get to use for that then?
Oh, go on, off you go, off you go. Quickly, 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 quickly. Oh, hello, I didn't see you all there. My name is Nanny Goose, and I have a favor to ask each and every one of you. Every time I enter on stage and I say, hello, my darling ducklings, could you all reply, quack, quack, Nanny Goose?
Yeah.
Does that sound like something you can do?
Yeah.
Wonderful. We'll have a practice run now. I'll say the line, you say your line, and we'll see how it goes, all right? Hello, my darling ducklings.
Quack, quack, Nanny Goose.
Ooh, very good. You're fast learners, a lot of you. Okay, let me try this with a fake entrance, all right? I'll leave, I'll come back on, I'll say the line, and you'll say your line, all right? Give me a second. Hello, my darling ducklings.
Quack, quack, Nanny Goose.
Ooh, wonderful. Call and response. I love this. There's an awful lot of you, aren't there? Did you all RSVP to the Facebook invite? Come on now, we all know responding interested isn't very helpful now, is it? Well, gosh, I don't know if there's enough food for everybody. Make sure you save enough for me. I've got to get ready. I have a christening to prepare for. And speaking of which, you should all be getting ready too. I hope you don't plan on attending looking like that. Unless you hadn't heard. The Queen has given birth to a beautiful baby called Primrose last week.
Aww.
Give her an arm, please. Oh, come on, she's cuter than that. A bigger arm.
Aww.
And as it happens, I've been appointed as her nanny, which means I've got a lot of work to be doing. I'm thinking of starting one of those Instagram accounts for her. You know, like the ones people have for their dogs. Gosh, I hope she's photogenic. Oh, the christening is about to begin. Yes.
Welcome, welcome, welcome all to this glorious day, the day of my daughter's christening. We are so glad you could all attend, and well, the turnout is even greater than we expected.
Yes, hence why we've run out of cubes of cheese and pineapple, and all we've got left are these dry sausage rolls.
Ah, the Queen and I couldn't be happier to finally be gifted with a beautiful baby daughter. We cannot wait to see what kind of woman she will become.
Probably barely want to know she's anything like her nanny.
Now, now, no heckling during the ceremony.
Villager number one.
Villager number one.
Get it?
Yes, right. We are so glad you could all attend, and the turnout, well, it's even greater than we expected.
Yes, Bob, you've said that.
Yes, but, well, in that case, I think it's about time that we thank all of the people that have made this happen.
Yes, we'd just like to take this opportunity to thank Audible.com for sponsoring.
He was talking about the fairies.
Now, everybody, if I could introduce you to our savings. Fairy Faraday, Fairy Elvin, and Fairy Telfer. Girls, truly may all of this happen in the middle of the house. May our dreams come true.
I'm a dream. some gifts we'd like to give to young Primrose.
Balls! Did you guys think to bring anything?
No, nothing.
I didn't think to.
I'm just trying to not give her smallpox.
I'm going to give the princess the most important gift of all. The gift of beauty. Because let's be honest, she's not getting it from either of her parents.
Beauty? Oh, seriously, Alvin, that is so like you. You're so vain.
Oh my God, Telford, what is your problem? Why are you so negative all the time? This is why nobody likes you.
Beauty, because she can be hounded by boys every time she tries to go out. Have you seen the ratios in Loveland? I'm going to give her the most important gift of all, the gift of intelligence.
Though, again, not coming from either of her parents.
Or from you.
Oh, pack it, Jane!
Now that you've all stopped bickering, I have the most important gift to give. I don't think so.
Hello, my darling ducklings.
Quack!
hasn't it? And with the rate Princess Primrose is growing, she barely has any need for a nanny anymore.
Aww.
Oh, don't worry, it's all right. I've got a lot of spare time on my hands now, which means I've really been able to commit to the dating game again. And let me tell you, I've been seeing quite a few men, you know, from a distance, around the castle, through windows and such. And I've got this great new job in the kitchen. I'm really learning a lot.
Ha! All you do is peel potatoes.
That is not true. I also sweep confetti.
Well, obviously not very well. That's apparently been there for 13 years.
Oh, pack it in. You're not even in this scene.
Oh, yes, I am.
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
No, you're not. I was going to say, it's rather peaceful here in the kitchen. The royals don't tend to bother me down here. Oh, is it now, Primrose?
Mommy and Daddy never let me do anything.
Oh, darling, you know that's only because they love you.
They barely let me leave the palace.
I seem to remember there's a reason for that. Last time you wanted to leave, where was it you wanted to go?
Just wanted to try it.
You know full well you're far too young to be going to Echoes. To be honest, I wouldn't recommend it at any age.
Now that's terribly cross
me
again.
Why, what's wrong?
How was I supposed to know? The label on the bottle was so confusing, and I'd already drunk about half of it before Daddy told me it was bleach.
Primrose!
It's not my fault! I didn't realise. And anyway, it looked so appetising. Almost as good as those laundry pots.
Darling, you really must stop skipping lunch. Perhaps you're just hungry.
Maybe. What is for dinner, Nanny Goose?
Chicken cassoulet with potatoes and salad niçoise.
As usual. You remember how I like my chicken, Nanny?
Yes, Primrose. Medium rare.
I just feel like every day is the same here. I'd go to bed at 9 here, then at 4 a.m. I'd have a dream where you're dressing up as a sheep for an Instagram photo. 5 a.m. the clock will stop going. 6 a.m. I stop getting up. Then 7 a.m. the usual morning lineup. Storm the chores and sweep till the floors all clean. Polish your wires, do laundry and mop and shine up. Sweep again and by then it's like 7:15. So I'll read a book or maybe 2 or 3. I'll add a few little things to my gallery. I'll play guitar and fit and cook it basically. Just wonder when will my life begin.
No, Primrose, it's really difficult being a princess, isn't it?
Tell me about it.
Barely done a day's housework in her life.
Primrose felt she was all alone.
But in a far-off land over the heir to a little throne,
where a prince was waiting for his life to begin,
and eagerly dreaming of when he could be king.
So we take you now to the realm of Ashby de la Souche.
Where? Really? You're going to do this to me? Whoosh!
On guard, Crosby! I've got you this time.
Very good, sir. Well, that training is certainly paying off.
Yes, indeed. Father would be letting me play with scissors again in no time. What's that?
That would be a duck, sir.
Marvellous.
Could we perhaps return to the training now, sir?
Yes, of course.
Ready? And left, right, left, right, left! No, sir. Your other left.
Don't be ridiculous, Crosby. There's only one left. Everybody knows that.
Except for whoever it was you left your prey.
I grow tired of all this training, Crosby. I want to go out into the world, go on quests to save kingdoms, to slay trolls and kiss girls.
As noble as that sounds, sir, I think you may still have a way to go. Slay a troll. Unfortunately, I fear you struggle to slay that duck.
Don't be ridiculous. You saw the size of that mighty rat I slay in Mummy's chambers.
Indeed I did, sir. Although that was in fact a hamster. And as it happens, your hamster. And made slightly less impressive the reason you're in Mummy's chambers was because you had a nightmare that Mr. Blobby was running the Union Press.
A minor setback! Crosby! What have I told you about addressing me by my title?
Ah, my apologies, Prince. Prince. Yes, all right, we're running out of ideas.
Besides, I'm nearly a man now. You know, I drank a coffee the other day.
There's more to being a man than drinking coffee, my liege. You need to have responsibilities. A job. You've got to get up each morning and earn a living, shoveling manure in the local stables. And you might not want to do it, but you have to, because you've got six kids. And a wife, who all need new shoes, and you've got to make time for them and take them to birthday parties, and you've got to make sure there's enough soap in the house and then get picked on because smelling like horse poo, and your wife can't work because she's only got one leg, and the dog's dying of prostate.
Oh, no. I can see what you need the coffee.
Exactly, sir. And why you need to practice your sword fighting, so you can defend those working men.
I do practice my sword fighting, Crosby. My brothers and I practice every day.
Not that kind of sword fighting. Really, sir, sometimes I wonder what kind of a king you're going to become.
Me? Well, gonna be a mighty king, so enemies beware.
Well, I've never seen a king of men who's quite so unaware.
Gonna be the main event, no king was before. I'm brushing up, I'm looking down, polishing my sword.
The father of an unimpressive thing.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
You grow all the way to go beyond the ostrich, you think.
No one's saying do this.
When I said that,
no one's saying be there.
I meant was.
No one's saying stop that.
What you don't realize.
No one's saying see here.
Now see! Yeah!
Free to run around all day.
I'm stepping out.
Free to do it all my way.
I think it's time that you and I reach the hot pot.
Kings don't need advice from horse poop shovelers for a start.
This is where the monarchy is headed. Out of the outs, out of service, out of Ashby. I wouldn't hang about to find out what the disaster he will bring.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
Everybody look left, everybody look right.
Ready? And right. Oh, for goodness sake.
Made of ice and cream. I have to make it
haven't washed my hands.
Really? Unbelievable!
Well, you didn't give me a chance.
I really think you're doing this on purpose, then.
Yes, I smear a rat.
No, I swear it was all an accident.
No, really. I smell a rat.
He's right. I do smell a rat. But where is the rat, audience? Can you see it?
It's a dark above. Fairies
sports competitions. Gee, they should respect me. I'm actually the oldest fairy. But no, they think that just because I'm a Unite student's fairy, they're better than me. Do you know I was voted best fairy in Leopard Tower's posting?
Boss, I don't think she's listening.
God, royals. No manners. Isn't it a lecture, Primrose? I expect you to stay awake.
To be fair, you did just send her to sleep and then start monologuing at her.
I don't pay you to talk back.
You don't pay me at all.
I don't feel so good. What have you done to me? Well, little princess, I put a spell on you. And now you're mine. You can't stop the things I do. I am line. Oh, been 18 years, right down to the day. Now the witch is back, and there's hell to pay. I put a spell on you.